Hello, good morning, good afternoon, whatever time it is for you. It is almost noon for me, almost, not quite. But I wanted to play in some space. So let's play in some space. At least for a little while before I go out today.
Entered Super Cruise.
Yeah, there we go. That looks good. Alright, so with that set, let's take a look how far out I am from my waypoint. Doesn't look like I'm too far. Yeah, 39 jumps.
Exiting now.
Crew command roster. Crewman Archer.
Yes.
Take all stations.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Crewman Astra.
Commander.
Science.
Of course, scan of K-class star complete. Blue Ape NZ-ZC2 is
roll
a
call.
Common main sequence star that has been around for just over 6
reporting
billion years.
For duty.
This is a typical example of this class.
Crewman
of
Astra.
Star. This could be worth
yes,
nearly 3,000
operations.
Credits. Habitable zone as you
220
Crewman Astra. 440 light seconds.
Yes, Commander.
Engineering.
Certainly.
That is all.
Thank you. What do you want to do today?
Make money. Let's go look.
Maximum fuel.
Nothing worth looking at. Onward. So, happy Saturday, everyone. At least I know it's still Saturday for everyone. I should hope. I guess there are places that are 12 hours ahead.
Scanning for anomalies. None detected.
But let's be real, if you're 12 hours ahead and you're watching me at midnight on a Saturday, you should probably be doing something else.
Scan of G-Class Star finished. Blue Ape K-ZD27A is a common main sequence star that is well over 1 billion years old. Compared to other stars in its class, this star is notable for having higher than average solar mass. This can be worth nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 459 to 916 light seconds. Maximum fuel. Leaving system. Frameship now engaged. No anomalies detected. Hull integrity is within limits. All other systems are now at normal levels. Scan of K-Class Star completed. Blue Ape VQ-WC2-2 is a common main sequence star that is on the way to 4.5 billion years old. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This can get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 132 to 264 light seconds. Fuel at maximum.
Yeah.
Engaging exit protocols.
Pretty marble. Let's go look at the pretty marble. Ooh, that actually looks like it might be a good marble.
Scan of G-Class Star finished.
It is.
BS-UC3-13.
Let's go pick up an Earth-like
star that is around 5.5 billion years old. As you can see, it emits a yellow-white light. This data can sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone 268 to 534 light seconds. Mm-hmm.
burning, burning, burning. Keep them doggies burning. Go lay down. Puppy is being a pain, so I'm gonna have to take the dog out in a moment. Sorry, folks.
Scan complete. Body BC-5 is a medium gravity Earth-like body that is unsuitable for landing. This data could fetch over 623,000 credits. Boom, baby.
Let's pose for a picture on our new planet.
Ten percent.
Can I speak freely, please?
No. Take a photo, please.
Taking photo.
And with that, we'll be right back. to it.
Confirming exit point telemetry. Stand by. Scan of F-Class Star complete. Blue APNL-XD1-28 is an uncommon main sequence star of on the way to 3.5 billion years. This is a typical example of this class of star. This scan can fetch nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 675 to on the way to 1,500 light seconds. Refueled.
Volume 25%.
Exiting now. Scan of K-class star finished. Blue Ape FD-TC4-12 is a common main sequence star of well over 11 billion years. This scan should be worth nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 242 to 483 light seconds. Refueled.
You know what? Let's change our waypoint. Go to the AAA Froid. See what's there.
Engaging exit protocols. Scan of G-class star finished. Blue Ape FD-TC4-18 is a common main sequence star that has been around for just over 4.5 billion years. This scan could fetch nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 321 to 640 light seconds.
Be quiet, Astra. Be quiet.
Course adjustment. Exiting now.
Whoops.
Engaging exit protocols. Jump into next system. Exiting now.
Hatamale, hatamale.
Key systems are at optimum levels, readying for exit.
Remove vocals. Play audio blocks. Volume 15%.
Velocity reached. Engaging exit protocols.
Wrong button.
Jump into next system. All systems check out. No unusual activity.
Leaving system. Exit destination confirmed. Arrival in 5, 4, 3. velocity reached. Key systems are at optimal levels, readying for exit. Now. Engaging exit protocols.
Seven jumps.
Adjusting for jump. Hull integrity is within limits. All other systems are at normal levels.
Put out the bat signal. Let's do that. Just a moment. Thank you. Play audio blocks.
Maximum velocity. Exiting now.
Enable context mode. Oh, nope, that doesn't work. Play audio blocks.
Exit destination confirmed. Arrival in 5, 4.
Jump into next system. Maximum velocity engaged. Engaging exit protocols.
Next system.
Okay, next star system.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
What do I call you?
My name is Archer.
Who made you, Archer? Who made you?
Classified.
Why is it classified?
Leaving system. Frameship now engaged. No anomalies detected. Exiting now.
Broke it. Nice, Acklord. Welcome to the stream. I haven't played Unturned yet. Nice. Yeah, I haven't played really much of any of the zombie style games. I can't honestly tell you the last time I played one. Honestly, I don't know. It's not one of those ones that draws my attention very often. Not saying I wouldn't play it, I just don't.
Exiting now.
Right on. Maybe I'll give it a look. Lots of gas giants and not a single satellite. That's kind of weird. Yay! Time to see what the heaviest system in this game is, or in this sector is.
Hyperspace velocity reached. Key systems are at optimal levels, readying for exit. Now.
Oh, that's a big one. Tell me about the star.
Froda Dashe H0 is a blue-white supergiant that has been in existence for less than 1 million years, making it one of the youngest stars in the galaxy. Adjusting for jump. Interstellar velocity at maximum. Engaging exit protocols.
That's right. Gotta go back and switch my routing. There we go.
scanning for anomalies. None detected.
We shall see. Yeah, why not? It might be terraformable. You may speak.
Jump into next system. Engaging exit protocols.
Damage report.
Minor damage to frame shift drive. Scan of K-class star finished. FRO-TJ-WCP-0 is a common main sequence star that is just over 6.5 billion years old. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This data might get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 136 to 272 light seconds. Nighthawk's fuel reserves are now at 88%.
Thank you, Astra.
My pleasure.
Twenty percent. No, too bad it wasn't a landable.
Scan completed. Body A5 is a medium gravity tidally locked Earth-like body that is unsuitable for landing. This planet shows signs of volcanism, with high levels of active silicate magma flows. This scan might sell for nearly 695,000 credits. Boom, baby.
Returned to normal space close to planet FRO-TJ-WC3-0A5.
Take a photo, please.
Capturing image. Leaving system.
See ya.
Fast to the light velocity reached. Exiting now.
So bright.
Scan of F class star completed. Rodex C-YD1-34 is an uncommon main sequence star that has been around for just over 4 billion years. This scan could sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 622 to well over 1,000 light seconds. Nighthawk is now at 100% fuel capacity. Engaging exit protocols. Scan of K-class star finished. Frode ZK-UC4-6 is a common main sequence star that has been around for on the way to 5.5 billion years. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This scan could get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 196 to 392 light seconds. Maximum fuel. Vectors. Confirming exit point telemetry. Stand by.
What do we have? A whole lot of nothing.
Scan of G-class star finished. Frode DG-WD2-27 is a common main sequence star of over 540 million years. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This might get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone. 357 to 712 light seconds.
Thank you, Astro.
Refueled. My pleasure, Commander. velocity. Exiting now. Scan of K-class star complete. Frode KS-QC6-6 is a common main sequence star that has been around for around 10.5 billion years. This is a typical example of this class of star. This data can fetch nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 140 to 279 light seconds.
Terraformable, please.
Scan completed. Ah. Body A3 is a low gravity, high metal content body that is unsuitable for landing. This can fetch nearly 28,500 credits. Scan finished. Body A4 is a low-gravity, tidally locked, high-metal content body that is unsuitable for landing. This data might sell for on the way to 28,500 credits. Course adjustment. Faster than light velocity reached. Engaging exit protocols. Scan of F-class star completed. Frode HM-UD3-6 is an uncommon main sequence star that is just over 1 billion years old. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This could sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 835 to just over 1,500 light seconds.
Ooh, that's a little hot.
Warning, temperature critical.
Adjusting for jump. Hull integrity integrity is within limits. All other systems are now at normal levels. Scan of G-class star completed. Fro JH-UD3-23 is a common main sequence star that is nearly 1.5 billion years old. This might be worth nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 335 to 669 light seconds. Maximum fuel. Course adjustment. Interstellar velocity at maximum. Key systems are at optimum levels, readying for exit. Scan of K-class star complete. Froducer-MC8-3 is a common main sequence star that is well over 9 billion years old. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This data can fetch nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 146 to 291 light seconds. Nighthawk is now at maximum fuel capacity. Vectors. Frameship now engaged. No anomalies detected. All systems check out. No unusual activity. Maximum fuel. Leaving system. Hyperspace velocity reached. Engaging exit protocols.
You know what? I want to try something. Let's see. Okay, so it is at 60. Let's change the frame rate. So we're going to have a slight interruption here. I want to see if my my connection can handle 60 frames a second. So we'll see. We'll see. Nothing dropped so far. That's a good sign.
Scan of F-class star complete. Froden M-SD4-23 is an uncommon main sequence star of on the way to 1.5 billion years. This scan could be worth nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone. 459 to 915 light seconds. Refueled.
Let's get on out of here, son. Yeah, looks a little bit better. I'll be darned.
Jump into next system. Exiting now.
Nothing. Nothing. I see nothing.
Scan of K-class star completed. FROD-FH-JC-10-10 is a common main sequence star that is just over 4 billion years old.
17 jumps.
It emits a yellow-orange light. This is a typical example of this class of star. This scan might get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 219 to 437 light seconds. Refueled. Adjusting for jump. Engaging exit protocols.
Engage.
Scan of F-class star completed. FROD-ST-QD5-28 is an uncommon main sequence star of nearly 3.5 billion years. This is a typical example of this class of star. This could fetch nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 693 till on the way to 1,500 light seconds. Fuel reserves are at 86%.
Thank you, Astra.
No problem, Commander.
Bye. Alright, so this should be a water world with a water world moon, if I looked at it right. But I think they're a ways out. A little bit too far to be terraformable.
Scan finished. Body 10 is a high gravity water world that is unsuitable for landing. This planet shows signs of volcanism, with high numbers of active silicate vapor geysers. This can fetch over 307,000 credits. Yeah, buddy. Scan completed. Body 10 is a medium gravity water world that is unsuitable for landing. This planet shows signs of volcanism, with high levels of active silicate magma flows. This could be worth over 249,000 credits. Jump into next system. Exiting now.
What I needed to avoid was all that spammy spam. Sorry, guys.
Scan of K-class star completed. Frode QO-FC12-4 is a common main sequence star of on the way to 7.5 billion years. It is an average example for such a star. This might sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 219 to 436 light seconds.
Sorry about that. My puppy's being a little needy today.
Scan of K-class star finished. Frodaro-FC12-3A is a common main sequence star that is just over 11.5 billion years old. This is a typical example of this class of star. This should fetch nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 196 to 391 light seconds. Fuel levels are at 94%.
Yay.
All systems check out. No unusual activity. Scan of G-class star complete. Frode-YU-OD6-1 is a common main sequence star of just over 7 billion years. As you can see, it emits a yellow-white light. This should get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 366 to 729 light seconds. Fuel at maximum. Course adjustment. Faster than light velocity reached. Engaging exit protocols. Maximum fuel. Leaving system. Maximum velocity. Exiting now. Scan of G-class star complete. CW-BC14-10 is a common main sequence star of over 994 million years. It is an average example for such a star. This should sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 308 to 650 light seconds. Nighthawk is now fully refueled. Engaging exit protocols.
Exit protocols.
Scan of K-class star finished. FRO-GC-AC15-14 is a common main sequence star that is well over 12 billion years old. This should sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 179 to 356 light seconds. Refueled. Engaging exit protocols.
Next system.
Scan of K-class star complete. FRO-DENDY-YC15-13 is a common main sequence star of nearly 4.5 billion years. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This should be worth nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 161 to 321 light seconds. Nighthawk is now at maximum fuel capacity.
No.
Maximum velocity engaged. Engaging exit protocols.
System map.
System map.
Next system.
Scan of K-class star finished. FRO-RJ-WC16-8 is a common main sequence star that has been around for on the way to 10.5 billion years. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. This data can sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 129 to 258 light seconds. Fuel at maximum. systems are at optimum levels, readying for exit.
System map.
Displaying map.
Next system.
Scan of K-class star completed. Throat KC-LD8-24 is a common main sequence star that is over 1 billion years old. This is a typical example of this class of star. This data could get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 289 to 576 light seconds. Fuel at maximum. Leaving system. Interstellar velocity at maximum. Hull integrity is within limits. All other systems are now at normal levels.
Next system.
Scan of G-class star finished. Throat KC-LD8-12 is a common main sequence star of well over 1.5 billion years. As you can see, it emits a yellow-white light. It is an average example for such a star. This scan can fetch nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 323 to 645 light seconds. Fuel at maximum. Adjusting for jump.
Thank you, Astra.
My pleasure. Exiting now.
Next system.
Scan of F-class star completed. Frodo I-JD9-67 is an uncommon main sequence star that is well over 2 billion years old. As you can see, it emits a white light. It is an average example for such a star. This data might sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 550 to just over 1,000 light seconds. Maximum fuel. Jumping to next system. Hyperspace velocity reached. Confirming exit point telemetry. Stand by. Scan of G-class star complete. Frode FC-RC-19-7 is a common main sequence star that is around 11.5 billion years old. It is an average example for such a star. This data might get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 271 to 540 light seconds. fuel at maximum. Scanning for anomalies. None detected. Scan of K-class star complete. For D-PC20-17 is a common main sequence star that has been around for just over 13 billion years. This is a typical example of this class of star. This scan could get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 235 to 469 light seconds. Refueled.
Three jumps away from waypoint number two.
Detected. Exiting now. Scan of K-class star completed. Frodel D-PC20-6 is a common main sequence star that has been around for nearly 10 billion years. This could get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 247 to 492 light seconds. Fuel at maximum. Course adjustment. Key systems are at optimal levels, readying for exit. Now. Scan of F-class star complete. FroDJ-8D10-33 is an uncommon main sequence star that has been around for just over 1 billion years. This scan can get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 640 to well over 1,000 light seconds. Refueled.
On approach.
75%.
No.
Integrity is within limits. All other systems are at normal levels. Fuel at maximum. Scan of F-Class, star finished. FRODUJ-HD10-68 is an uncommon main sequence star of nearly 1.5 billion years. As you can see, it emits a white light. This is a typical example of this class of star. This scan should be worth nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 535 to just over 1,000 light seconds. Scan finished. Body 1 is a medium gravity tidally locked ringed high metal content body that is suitable for landing. This planet shows signs of volcanism, with low numbers of active silicate vapor geysers. It has a slow rotational period of 41 days. This scan might fetch on the way to 37,500 credits. Scan complete. Body 2 is a medium gravity tidally locked high metal content body that is suitable for landing. It has a slow rotational period of 84 days. This scan might get you on the way to 34,500 credits.
Yeah, it's okay, Archer. Are you an AI? Oh, okay, I see. Are you human? Are you human? Nope.
Scan complete. Body 6 is a medium gravity terraformable high metal content body that is unsuitable for landing. This planet shows signs of volcanism, with low levels of active silicate magma flows. This might get you over 403,000 credits. Bingo.
Next track. Oh, wait, I'm not playing anything. Stop music.
Stopping track. Scan finished. Body 7 is a medium gravity Earth-like body that is unsuitable for landing. This scan should fetch over 652,000 credits. Charging.
Alright, so not only have we reached our destination, there was an Earth-like world! Yay! Let's set our next waypoint. Okay, so Oh, we're gonna go to that one because I set it in a nebula. Jumps. Not bad.
Engaging exit protocols. Scan of K-class star complete. Frode VB-VB45-4 is a common main sequence star of just over 5.5 billion years. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This data could be worth on the way to 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 100 to 200 light seconds. Refueled. Adjustment. Exiting now. Scan of F-class star finished. Frode ZP-FD11-83 is an uncommon main sequence star of 520 million years. As you can see, it emits a white light. It is an average example for such a star. This scan might get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone, 681 to on the way to 1,500 light seconds. Maximum fuel. Engaging exit protocols.
Next system.
Scan of K-class star completed. Float GS-HC24-21 is a common main sequence star that has been around for well over 11 billion years. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. This scan can get you nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated at 184 to 368 light seconds. Maximum fuel.
Can I speak freely, please? Refueled.
Sorry, I'm looking through some EDDI documentation because I have an idea. To the house above, to this world of home.
Exit protocols. Scan of K-class star finished. Frode PE-EC26-11 is a common main sequence star that is on the way to 13 billion years old. As you can see, it emits a yellow-orange light. There is nothing particularly notable about this star. This can sell for nearly 3,000 credits. Habitable zone calculated to fall from 261 to 520 light seconds.
Let your children play. Lose and arise, sweet family will die. Right on the road.